hotel. The Clintmore Hotel at that. Not some family reunion in the back sticks of Louisiana.
We were just trying to have a little fun while cleaning, Miss Georgia.
We'll have fun wiping up this dust and cleaning this lobby.
Ooh, do you always gotta be such a
boss? Because that better be the only thing you were about to say.
You know me so well, Georgia.
That's Miss Georgia. Listen, I have a very important Zoom call this morning, so you two need to keep it down up here. Also, we have a very important check-in later. So you two need to be on your very best, utmost presentation. Remember, our guests choose our hotel because they come for the things and stay for the more. Exactly. So don't ruin it.
You know, she really gets on my nerves.
I ain't gonna lie, she is a tough cookie.
Tough cookie? You must mean one of those little biscuit things that Anne Hathaway was eating in The Sound of Music. Just hard and nasty.
Now, you do know Anne Hathaway wasn't in there, right?
Girl, I don't know what she was.
Never mind. But do you know who that special guest check-in is that she's expecting?
Now, you know Eveline does not share that with us peasants.
That's true, that's true.
But what we can do is look it up.
Yeah, come on, let's go.
Oh, girl, nah. You remember the last time you know who was here? Housekeeper was finding condoms for names.
Oh, you know that gospel concert is in town this weekend.
Mm-mm, you know they like to stay on my side of town.
A millionaire!
They're too far from luxury.
A rapper?
Too far from the hood.
A football player.
Too far from the stadium. Focus.
Well, then I don't know who it could be.
We just gonna look up. Who's checking into the presidential suite?
Good, Eric, hurry up.
I'm looking.
Hurry up!
I'm looking!
Hurry up!
I said I'm looking! Of course, she wanna have it blocked. You know that wanks really blows me.
Look at you thinking stupid! I told you to keep the wanks in the dark south!
What are you talking about, chicken?
Ain't nobody talking about no damn chicken, Ryan! This our lodge, not Popeye!
Why you asking me to do it anyway?
Because I had control of work! Remember the fucking people going that way?
Remember you used to be a nice loving wife!
Are still here.
And child don't look like they're going nowhere anytime soon.
Welcome to the Clintmore Hotel, where the guests come for the Clint and stay for the more.
Hi, I'm Eric.
And I'm Candace.
And we're the Randolphs.
Hi, Randolphs.
I'll need your ID and credit card if you're checking in.
So what brings you to our hotel?
Oh, well, we just got married and we're here celebrating our honeymoon.
Oh, that is so sweet. Well, you two have picked the perfect place to stay. Our hotel is one of the top rated stays in the area.
That's so refreshing to hear. I was a little concerned about the area, but everything just seems so peaceful and quiet.
Trust me.
It is.
We ain't trying to get to all over town, Ryan. Then go straight to Wings and Roasters, get the food, and come straight back.
Dang, woman, I don't need your help.
Are you sure? Because obviously you need it doing the laundry. Now look, I want 16 lemon pepper wings, all flat. Ooh, Ryan. And don't forget about my two extra large ranches. Okay, bye-bye.
I'm so sorry about that. Actually, give me a moment, okay? Just give me a second. I'm gonna be right back. Just give me a second. You check them in. Give me a moment. Candace, check them in. Ryan! Oh, Ryan, let me put a horn in! Ryan! I want some wings! Ryan!
Okay, so I have you in the deluxe city view room on the 10th floor. Is there anything else I can help you with?
Maybe you can give us good recommendations on dinner.
Something other than the wings and roasters?
I absolutely love this small family-owned Creole restaurant. It's just down the street. It's called La Cajon, baby. And the redfish.
But is it spicy though? Because baby can't handle spices or red sauce.
I can eat red sauce. I just can't digest it.
Now you know that digesting is part of eating it, right?
Are you making fun of my digestive system, Cole?
Nah, I ain't making fun of it. I'm just, yes, I'm making fun of it, baby.
All right, we'll see later tonight if it's still funny.
Ooh, don't do that to me, baby.
You two are the cutest couple ever. Do you mind if I ask where you met?
Well, we met
at the grocery store. She saw me picking up a 24-pack of water and couldn't take her eyes off me.
Are you serious?
She was like, oh my God, you're like so strong and sexy. My name is Stephanie, and I hope that you're single, and if you're not, I still want you.
Cool.
I had a girl at the time, so I was like, nah, I'm good.
Oh, you were good, huh?
She was like, oh please, please let me take you out, just once. I can't lie. I didn't like to see her, babe. So I agree, and it's been magic ever since.
Don't touch me. Don't listen to anything this dummy says. We met on a dating app where he swiped right, found my Instagram, and somehow stuck his way into my DMs because he was too cheap to pay for the messaging on the dating app.
But I wasn't too cheap on the first date, though, right?
I suppose. He's a pretty good Mandarin, and it was my first time using chopsticks. But it just became my thing.
I know the perfect place for you guys to go. It's called Mia Gardens. You're gonna absolutely love it. I can make reservations if you like.
Ooh, that would be perfect. We'll go upstairs and change and shower and head over there. If you can make those reservations.
I'll get right on it.
Thank you again, Candace.
My pleasure. Hello? I'd like to make a reservation for two, please. Cole and Stephanie Randolph. It's their honeymoon, so something nice if you can. Okay. Thank you. Wow. One day I hope to find a love like that. A love that makes me feel bubbly. And so sweet and vulnerable. A love that makes me feel like a woman. Looking out on the morning rain, I used to feel so uninspired. Help me claim it.
told me she heard it was a famous boxer.
Jackson in accounting told me that it was a supermodel.
Well, Anthony in maintenance said he heard it was Sasha and Malia Obama.
The Obamas?
That's what he said.
Really? Now, you know Anthony don't ever tell the truth.
Girl, but what if he is this time?
Knowing Georgia, she probably got us all getting ready for a great aunt or something.
Not a great aunt.
Did I hear my name?
No, ma'am. We were just saying what a joy it is to work here.
For it to be a joy, you don't seem to be doing much of it. Look, when our special guest arrives, he will be spending a lot of time at that bar. So it needs to be fully stocked and prepared.
Yes, ma'am.
We have so much riding on tonight that nothing, I mean nothing, can go wrong.
Okay, yes, ma'am.
Out of curiosity, do you mind sharing who tonight's special guest is? So we know how to govern ourselves.
We want to be able to, govern ourselves accordingly.
Why would I tell either of you anything? But if I did, you have to promise not to tell a single soul.
Promise?
Well, a friend of mine whom I used to, whom I used to, he now does security for some singer, and they will be staying here at our hotel.
Oh, a singer. Do I know? Do I know who he is?
I don't know who you children listen to these days, but I do care about how this hotel looks. Everything has to be perfect for our guest. Perfect.
I promise you, Miss Georgia, when that singer comes, he's going to have the best experience ever.
I don't care about the singer. Everything has to be perfect for my man.
Your man? Oh, you got a little boyfriend.
He's not my boyfriend. At least I don't think. I mean, we definitely have something that I can't explain. I mean, it's, I just get so. I don't know what it is that he's done to me. But it's caused me to act in such a crazy way. Whatever it is that he does when he does what he's doing. Oh, it's a feeling that I want to stay.
Something takes over me.
Well, damn, Miss Georgia, I ain't never seen you smiling like that.
And you never will if you don't get off your lazy butt and make this hotel perfect!
You know what? I hope her man breaks her back, eats her groceries, and tosses her salad enough for her to get off our back for at least 2 months.
Well, any man willing to do that is an
angel. Listen, look, look, look. Well, look what the cat drug in from lunch.
Did Georgia notice I was gone?
Girl didn't even ask about you. Yeah. She got her head so far up the clouds about tonight's guest, she wouldn't even know up from down.
And speaking of tonight's special guest, we figured out who the special guest was.
Yes. I already know who it is. Sasha and Malia Obama. Oh,
you can't be serious.
That's what Anthony down in maintenance told me.
Anthony is a liar. Trust me, I went out on a date with him.
You did what? Anyway, the special guest is, you ready? A singer.
Okay, who?
Okay, well, I didn't get a name. We didn't really get that far into it.
Yeah. But we do know that he's a man.
And he has security.
So which means he's probably a pretty famous man.
Oh, which means he probably makes pretty decent music.
Okay. Okay. Yeah. So you pretty much, you got nothing.
Pretty much. But what we did get is Miss Georgia's trying to get her cat scratched.
Yeah. TMI.
Well, if I'm lucky, she won't be the only one getting some this weekend. Because if it's going to be celebrities pulling up tonight, I'm pulling out my 50 perk. Yeah.
Listen, I know that's why you better spray me once or twice. I got to make sure the milkshake brings all the boys
out. Ridiculous.
Baby, ridiculously tired of working here. Listen, we're trying to get chose. Time is ticking, Candace.
Well, I'm not in a rush. I'm gonna wait for the perfect man. The man that God has for me. And I'd rather do that than to get stuck with the dudes that you two date.
I don't date. I simp.
But didn't you go on a date last night?
It was a simp.
Girl, bitch. Yeah,
and he took me to this most amazing rooftop restaurant with the most incredible views.
What's it called? View Seafood?
Yes, that's the one. But this fool went to the bathroom when the check came and never came back.
Girl, you can't be serious. The same thing happened to me. With this first time, this man I met at the gym, total eye candy, but broke as a joke.
And this is what you want me to be excited about? I mean, you can keep your date night sampling and all them horror stories that you got. But as for me, I'm going to keep practicing abstinence. I'm gonna keep practicing abstinence.
Ooh, help me, Lord!
Have you lost your mind?
No! I'm just not trying to sleep with every man that likes me.
First of all, we don't sleep with every man that likes us. Just the ones that spend money on us.
Oh, well, I want to fall in love.
Oh, okay, that's good.
I want to have a family. I want to get married. And now call me delusional, but I'm going to live happily ever after with my man.
Listen to yourself, Candace. You starting to sound like one of them characters off a damn Disney movie when this is real life.
Oh.
Yeah, you do sound like a little bit like Princess Tiana, girl. I'm just saying.
Yo, I'm serious. I want a deep connection.
Oh.
When that young couple checked in earlier today, I saw the love in their eyes.
Oh, it's beautiful.
And I know that God has somebody out there like that for me. And I'm not gonna settle for nothing less.
Listen to me.
If that man is out there,
he gonna want some.
And if he is as amazing as you say he is, you gonna have to give him some.
Because what one hoe won't do, another hoe will.
I'm a woman.
A real one.
And a patient one of them. And when my knight in shining armor comes along, oh, I'll be ready for it.
Okay, Rapunzel.
And at least Princess Tiana found her frog and turned him into a prince.
When a man finds a woman, he finds a good thing. Mm-hmm. Not when a woman finds a frog. She got to make him croak.
Well, how any man gonna find you, Candace? You don't even go nowhere. Well, he just gonna walk up in here and ask you to marry him.
I go places.
Wait, because I've asked you to go out with me and my girlfriends like a dozen times, and you said no every time.
I go to,
Girl, that's just sad. That's sad. Listen, all I'm saying is, if Georgia's got a man, then they must be running out. No. You need to hurry up and get Charles Campbell.
Now listen, y'all. I respect y'all's choices, okay? But this is something personal for me. And when the right man comes along, I'll know it. Because he'll want the same things as me.
Wait, I hope he hurry up and come along soon, because abstinence, hot, rub me out the plastic, I'll be acting brand new.
Listen, I know that's right, friend. Listen,
I'm a hoe.
So I'm gonna tell you my exciting, when am I exciting dating life?
Okay.
Wow, watch out now, it's the little one, and it's not my wife.
Forget your man. I hope her man gets here ASAP.
Should have been here by now. Oh. Okay, just calm down, Georgia. He's on his way. Don't worry about it. Just take a deep breath. Okay, all right. Oh, everything's fine. He's probably just. Stopping to get a bite to eat, or maybe he just got stuck in a little bit of traffic. maybe he got in his car accident and he slipped over on the side of the road. And now he's in the hospital, the emergency room, and I'm wondering fucking about him not being here on time. And he can't even talk, and he's eating through a breathing tube. Let me check the news. Together, Georgia. Everything's fine. He's only 4 minutes late. Oh, it's fine.
Oh, I just can't believe that
We're finally going to see each other after all these years. Finally get to have that moment. Our moment. This hotel lobby has seen so many stories, so many love stories, so many memories. Oh, and I'm finally gonna get mine. Oh, you're finally gonna get your man, Georgia. And nothing, I mean nothing, is gonna stop me. He's gonna be mine at last. Guest arrives.
Okay, yes, ma'am. Welcome to the Clickmore Hotel, where the guests come for the click and stay for the more.
And what is that supposed to mean?
We don't know.
She likes to go to bed with your ID and credit card.
Actually, I will be checking into two rooms, one for my client and the other one for myself and our security.
So, you're the... I better go and get...
Get me. You should let me handle it. Move out the way. Hi, I'm Eric, and I'll be handling all of your needs on today. So who did you say your client was?
Corey James.
Corey James! Ooh, Corey James!
Oh, my God, yes!
Corey James!
Will you keep it down, please? Ooh. I don't want everyone to know that we stand at this hotel.
Corey! told me this is gonna be a good job.
I'm gonna finish getting you checked in. So I have Mr. James in the presidential suite, and the other room is down the hall. Did you need help with your bags? I'll call the bellhop for you.
Yes, thank you.
Yes, ma'am.
You dial one number and I'm gonna bite your finger off. Put the phone down. I'm getting those bags and I'm going to the room of Corey James. Corey! Here I come, Corey!
Ooh, nobody's gonna believe us if it is.
I'm gonna get a photo with him.
No, we got to get a video.
Or a FaceTime. I'm gonna get him to FaceTime Mama.
What if he sings our song?
Oh, if he sings our song, that'll just be further confirmation that we're meant to be.
These two, it made me sick. I'm going to the mall.
There's so many people in the lobby.
I don't know, but it's good for business, right? Because everybody's been ordering drinks and paying me tips.
Look, you didn't tell anybody about our special guest saying it, did you?
No.
Are you sure?
I'm positive.
You know the number one rule of hospitality is guest privacy, so we cannot compromise that or betray that.
But, have you seen my special plan?
No. Me neither. Oh, do you think I should go up to this room and knock on the door?
And say what?
Hello? It's me. I was wondering after all these years if you would like me.
Don't say that.
Oh, all right. Welcome to the clipboard, home of the clipboard. May I take your order?
Are you okay? No. You've been acting kind of strange. Maybe you should just kind of wait till he calms down. Guess privacy is top priority!
You're right! I'll just stay out of the way and wait for him to notice me. And then I'll play all soft and coy. That'll turn it on, right?
Who told you that Corey James was coming down, let alone staying at this hotel?
That one over there.
Excuse me for a moment.
Babe, see if they got some Hennessy.
Babe, you got money for Hennessy?
Give him a shot of Jack Daniels. He ain't gonna know the difference.
I told you this hotel was gonna be exciting. We're about to see Corey James!
Whoa, I'm so excited. First I married the man of my dreams, then I get to see one of my favorite singers.
Hurry up, Jackie! They doing it again!
Can you tell me what's going on here?
Well, I see what had happened was.
See what had happened was nothing! You know the number one rule of hospitality is guest privacy! Now you are going to tell the guests that Corey James is not staying down here and that they need to go back to their rooms immediately.
Well, I can't do that, actually.
Oh, so. You can, and you will.
Excuse me, everyone. Everyone, excuse me. I know that many of you were staying here and you had the expectation and even had the hope that you were going to be meeting a celebrity on tonight. But,
Hey, get out, Trent! The celebrity on his way down!
Can't you see me coming? If you was a gentleman, you would have at least got your broke ass over here to help me carry them.
I thought you was a strong, independent black woman.
Well, I'm an independent drink the both of these if you don't shut the hell up.
As I was saying, I know that you all were expecting to meet the special guest tonight, but unfortunately,
oh my god.
See, when I said that he was staying here, I may have been misinformed, and I think I may have
Corey Jerry!
Everyone calm down!
Moses!
How you doing?
What is this? Did somebody tip the press off? I'm so very sorry. It seems as though somehow our guest found out that Mr. James was staying here, but don't worry, no one else will find out.
Somehow I don't believe you.
And whose idea was it to stay at this hotel anyway? I know not security, whose job is to secure us. And secure you will be. People, there's nothing to see here. Everyone, back to your rooms. Back to your rooms.
Corey James got down here. We ain't quite that well.
I said back.
You ain't got no snack with.
My name is Eric. I'm your biggest fan. I follow you on all social media, and I listen to all of your people.
I'm your biggest fan. You know, I just love your song, Rolling. In the streets, in the mall, in the car, we roll.
Girl, get over here. You sound stupid. That ain't even how it goes. In the streets, in the car, in the mall, we roll.
You sound stupid.
In the streets, in the mall, in the car, we rolling. We rolling. We together and we rolling.
What?
Well, I just came to see if Mr. James wanted something to drink. You know, I have amazing.
Or we were seeing if he wanted something from the kitchen. We can bring you some chocolate cake.
Mr. James is not in need of anything right now. You two go back to their desk or something.
I'm the bartender. My job.
Well, then go tend the bar. Mr. James. So happy to have you here. Welcome to the Clintmore. Where the guests come for the Clint, and stay for the more.
Appreciate you for having me. It's a beautiful hotel you got here.
Thank you. And Moses.
George.
Oh, thank you so much for contacting me when it comes to taking care of your needs. For a place to stay.
Yeah, every city we go to, I look up old friends on Facebook. And when I saw that you worked here, I thought it'd be an amazing place for us to stay.
So you was looking me up on Facebook.
So this is awkward. I'm going to be headed to the car so we can be on time for our radio interview. Hopefully you can wrap this up and join us in the near future. Come on, Corey.
All the time.
I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to get you in trouble.
That's all right. She's really sweet. She just means business.
Yes. It's good to see you. What's it been, like 5 or 6 years?
Yeah, it's been a while.
Oh. You know, I probably don't look the same, but I still keep it together.
You always had it together, if I remember correctly.
Oh, not like you. Oh, your muscles. Oh, your muscles are muscling. Oh, and your beard. Oh, you smell of cocoa butter and sesame. And if I remember your eyes. Oh, your eyes. They hazel in the light and umber in the night.
We still talking about me?
Yeah.
of us. Just so refreshing that you're so humble.
I'm just like everybody else. And speaking of everybody else, they must be wondering where I'm at. So I better be going.
Oh, well, I don't want you to keep them waiting, so. Okay.
But it's really good seeing you, though, George. And thank you again for your hospitality.
Oh, well, I would do anything to you. I mean, for you. for you.
I appreciate that, Mama. Thank you.
That man is amazing!
Oh, George! You okay?
Girl. Oh. No. Did you see him?
Yes, Miss Georgia, he was fine!
Cool, fine! Ooh. Were you in his presence? Did you not smell him? Ooh, girl! That man is a god.
A god.
Oh, and I am his goddess. Oh, a man like that makes you feel wanted.
Wanted.
Makes you feel loved.
Love.
Makes you feel on top.
On top.
You feel it rising.
Feel
it. Oh, he's Bye.
clear you got feelings for him. But I'm sure he got feelings for you too. So why you out still at work and not out partying with your man?
He's here for work.
Work ain't all night. What about when he get off? Now, if he has not made plans to take you two out today, you may just have to drop him.
Look, you know what? You know what?
How about you just mind your business and get back to work?
I was just trying to help y'all think you said.
Can I ask a silly question?
What now, Lola?
Does your guy friend know how you really feel about him?
Of course he knows how I feel. I mean, I think he knows. I mean, let me see how to put this. It's just, I think that he...
Oh, he don't really know how you feel, huh?
No.
Well, you know, this is amazing love story ever, Miss Georgia. This reminds me that one time when I was at the Real Housewives of New York City, my homegirl Sonya, she was secretly dating this man, but she ain't want my man to know because you know how they.
No! Look, a man like that belongs in my fantasy.
Wow, Miss G. Come on, you haven't seen how excited and happy you get every time you think about this Moses guy. Now, it may have been my drink pouring skills that you hired me for, but it's gonna be my man catching skills that's gonna win you over. Now, come on! I got a plan! Come on, yes! Come on!
Oh, I don't
come
know.
On!
Is anybody working up here?
How can I help you?
Oh. I came up here for an extra room key. There's two of us in a room, but you guys only gave us one key. Being saved. That was my mom's favorite Bible story.
You grew up in the church?
I'm still growing up in the church. You know, you can never leave too far from your foundation.
That's so true.
Quickly give my freedom.
in your captivity. I am ready for love and all the joy and the pain and all the time that it takes just to stay in your good grace. Lately I've been thinking maybe you're not ready for me. Maybe you think I need to learn maturity. Said watch what you ask for, 'cause you might receive. And if you ask me tomorrow, I'll say the same thing. I am ready for love. Will you please lend me your ear? I promise I won't complain. I just need you to acknowledge I am here. If you give me half a chance, I'll prove this to you. I will be patient, kind, faithful, and true to a man who loves music, a man who loves art, respects the spirit world and think with his heart, his heart. I am ready for love, here with offering up my voice, my mind, my soul, my time. Tell me what is enough to prove I am ready for love.
There was the way that he looked at me. Oh, and I just knew that he won't sing.
And you sure about this?
I am. Oh, I think he's my knight shadow.
Oh, okay. Then why did you let him leave?
I don't know.
I don't know. It all just happened so fast. But he's staying here. And he'll be back. He'll be back.
Well, okay, so listen, what we're gonna do is, we're gonna make sure that when he comes back, you are ready to claim what's yours. Now come with me. I got a plan. So how long you and your wife been married?
Too damn long.
And how long is that?
Too damn long was the moment after I said I do. How long you been stuck in hell?
2 days now.
There's a thing called unknowing. It's not too late for you.
Well, I love my wife.
Oh, right now you do. Until she gets to yelling, screaming, and telling you what to do. And calling you stupid. And saying you nothing. Trust me. It's coming.
Well, me and my wife don't talk to each other like that. We're on the same page.
You'll see soon enough.
Eric! Where have you been? And did you finish getting the towels yet? And Mr. Frazier is over there giving marriage advice to the newlywed, and we all know how that's about to go.
Look, sorry, I've just been a little bit busy.
Busy doing what? Because I haven't seen you or Candace in an hour or two.
It's been that long. Did Georgia notice? Where she at?
No, she's been busy. I've been helping her with a special little project.
Well, your timing couldn't be any better. See, I've been working on a special little operation with my girl Candace.
Oh, an operation. You know I'm nosy, feeling deep.
Okay, so first what we was gonna do was... Matter of fact, I can show you better than I can tell you, okay?
Hey, Miss Georgia! Miss Georgia! Miss Georgia!
How come it seems like every time I come into this hotel, no one seems to be working? And you wanted to come here again for what?
Georgia's good pizza. She promised to take good care of us.
Tell her she's failing.
Man, I'm trying to drink.
Surprise!
No one is working the bar either.
Say, is there any room over there for me?
Absolutely!
Ooh, you are my biggest fan. Ooh, I listen to your music all the time. Please, me and my wife. Ooh.
Listen, Cora, I'm gonna go up to my room and I'll check on you later.
Ain't no need to check on me, yet. I'm gonna be all right.
I'm sure you will. I'm gonna go up to the room, keep an eye on him, because you know how he gets when he starts drinking.
I got it.
It'll be an honor if I can buy you a drink, Mr. James.
Mr. James, that's my deadbeat dad. Call me Corey.
Well, can I buy you a drink, Corey?
You know who that is? Man, that man got more money than you, me, and everyone in here. You won't let us buy you a drink, right, buddy? So, what do you want? Brown or clear? See, look, that would it depends on this. You trying to get the Good Morning America cord or the Shave Room cord? I ain't never seen Good Morning America, and I ain't about to start now, so let's turn up! Say, Liz, let's do this. Look, hold up. I don't know where the chick at the bar is at, but I know this spot around the corner. I let you get a section of three strippers. For $350.
Man, that sounds like a busted up hole in the wall.
Let's go. I'm telling you. Hey,
hold on.
Let me get rid of my. Yeah, let me get rid of that first.
Hey, Moses. Yes, sir. What's up, brother?
What's up, my boy? Hey, man, look, it's getting a little cold out here. It's chilly. You go get my hoodie for me real quick?
No problem. I'll be right back.
Ta!
Let's go.
No.
Come on. Hey,
I don't know about this.
I am on my honeymoon.
I was supposed to go downstairs, get some towels, and go back to my room.
Man, don't be a punk.
think about it like this. Your wife, we're gonna spend a lifetime with. Or a few hours with Grammy Award-winning Corey James! Yeah, for everything! But when you put it like that,
is that what you're gonna tell your wife?
No.
Then what are you gonna tell your wife?
Nothing! Man, my wife don't play like that! Oh. Man, let's get out of here before she kills us up.
Change first, so we decided she got dressed here first. That's right.
Well, you look ridiculous, especially since I need both of you to stay late, mandatory overtime.
Sorry, I can't do it. I already got plans. I done made me a little DA, and I can't cancel.
A what?
A DA. Did you want to see pictures? Let me show you. Hold on. You want to see?
Bow. I will pass. Look, you either cancel your DA or find another job. The overtime is mandatory. Lola, get on. You better find out where he went, or you will be the first one in the unemployment line.
I'm so sorry, Eric. This was a dumb idea. This is not me. I'm gonna take this shit.
You know, she really gets on my nerves. And look how she got my girl Candace feeling.
She's just misunderstood.
I know you're not defending Cruella DeVille.
And she ain't that bad, Eric, okay? I mean, of course, she's a little rude.
Look up to you.
Condescending. You know that.
It's real,
a little uncivil. Damn. What was I gonna say about her?
Listen, what happened to her Prince Charming? She was walking around here smiling and dancing like the black ghetto Mary Poppins when she thought he was gonna be here.
He is here, right? Then she was all dressed up.
That was her dressed up?
Well, I did what I could with what I had to work with.
Oh, you did that, friend? Oh.
You remember my little special little operation?
Georgia, what's your operation? That's a big operation. That's a big girl.
Hey,
running to say that my ass is on the line. I gotta hurry up and find out, baby, break her back before he breaks my face.
Hold on, time out. This night is getting a little more interesting. First, Georgia getting her back broke, and Candace say her knight in shining armor came in here and stabbed into her soul.
Can't be serious.
That's what she said.
That's so beautiful.
But listen, that's why I got her dressed up.
You did that. You did that, friend. Yeah. Oh, Candace needs to dress like that every night.
Baby.
Hey, well, now we just need to get Miss George to see her special friend and get Candace Knight on her armor to see her. And then you keep your DA up over there. I just keep my J-O-B.
Listen, that sounds like a plan to me, friend. Go ahead. We got to go get it. Oh, that was a lot of booty, but go ahead.
Painful.
And if you want to, girl, I can do the exact same thing for your husband's ass.
I think I'll pass.
Well, let me know if you change your mind.
Where do you think they went?
Went? Oh, honey, I know exactly where they are. Oh. Been married for like a couple of hours, so you don't even understand that you're gonna have to watch your husband's every move. See, I know where Ryan is more than his right ball know where his left ball is at.
So you don't trust him?
Trust? Oh, honey, I trust him all right to mess up. Okay. See, Ryan is what you would call a slut.
Like an athlete?
No. More like a dummy.
So why are you with him?
Because that's my man. And I'm gonna stick beside him.
What you have doesn't sound healthy. Sounds toxic.
It sounds like life. And as you continue to live, you're gonna start to understand what I'm talking about, baby girl. Do you work here? She must be talking to you, because I don't look like I work here.
You got that right.
No, I'm sorry. I don't know where any other staff is.
Of course. I don't know what the clip we come for, but I sure know they need more employees. I have a question, and I hope you don't make a big deal about it.
Oh, yeah. That ain't real. All natural. See, you can't buy something like this. I got this from my mama. Just call it the birth of Gene Wilder. Period.
No. I just want to ask, do you all know who Cora James is?
Ooh. Yeah, trust me. We know who he is.
Well, nice. I'm his manager, Vanessa, and we so happen to be staying here at the Clemore Hotel. And I was wondering, have you all happened to see him in the lobby or the area anywhere? Because I cannot seem to get him or our security on the phone.
You must not know, do you? You must ain't got like social media or something. See, Corey James, my husband, and her husband, oh, they around the corner at the Beautiful Nightmare making it rain, baby.
Beautiful Nightmare?
Yeah, the whole Wall Street Club around the corner.
Oh, no, I can't have my client in a place like that. I need to go and get him. I gotta get him out of there.
Calm the nines, baby. See, my husband already know. He got about 7 minutes to get here. Before I start to boil his teeth, with his own pits. And I meant it.
She did. I was here when she said it.
They should be here in about 5, 4, 3, 2.
I'm back. I'm here. I made it.
Ryan, Eugene, Deontay, Frazier, I can't believe you got me out here with my hair wet. And you know how I hate my hair being wet when I get out of the shower.
I'm sorry, baby. I'm sorry.
Oh, you gonna be real sorry when I'm done with you.
Why didn't you just tell me you were leaving?
I wanted to.
I wouldn't have minded.
I really did. Would you forgive me? I love you. See, babe, why you can't be like her?
Because I ain't her.
What are you doing in a strip club? You know a place like that is not good for PR. And where is Moses at?
Man, you being too uptight.
Uptight is my job. That's why you successful.
Man, I'm successful because I'm talented.
True that.
But you still need some discipline.
Nah, what I need, I need a little fun. I need a little entertainment. I need to be crazy sometimes. Man! There you are!
Moses, where you been?
Man, he tricked me. He told me to go get his hoodie. When I came back, he was gone.
Now, I know he can be a bit much, but I brought you on because I know that you're the best at what you do. And I know you can handle it.
No, I got it. Hey, Nessa. Is it right if me and my new friends, you know, have a few drinks and chill in the park for a little while? Or is it time for the baby to go to bed? Hey.
Okay, Corey. Just for a little bit because we have an early morning. I'm gonna keep my phone on me. Call me if anything come up.
All right, good night.
Okay, if you look at you like that earlier, wait till he sees you. Not like
will make sure that he has everything that he needs. Now get back to your desk.
Yes, ma'am.
Lola,
you said he would notice me. You said to dance. You said we'd be in love right now. You said this would work.
Body was. I don't know.
Well, you won't have to worry about being in the unemployment line because you will be in the morgue. Figure it out now.
This is a disaster. If this is gonna work, it's gonna work the way he saw me. I'm gonna take it out.
Eric.
Lola.
Wait, now what was Candace all up in Miss George's man's face?
Miss George's man? That's Candace's knight in shining armor.
That's Candace's knight in shining armor.
Ooh.
We gonna be in trouble.
What you talking about, Willis?
That's Miss George's special friend. She been trying to get his attention all night.
No, that's the man that Candace said that God sent for her. You know she's not gonna never find another man like that. She don't go nowhere.
Well, Miss Georgia said she's gonna fire me if I don't get her man.
Oh, well, we can't tell Candace to give her man to Miss Georgia. That's our friend.
Yes, we can.
No, we can't.
Yes, we can.
I said no,
yes, we can. Now look, we can find Candace a new man or we can find another Candace. But I am not losing this good paying job because of her.
I am not gonna hurt my friend's feelings so you can get paid to do nothing.
Now that was very hurtful, Eric. Now you know how hard I work at doing nothing up here.
I know. Well, you gonna have to start doing something. Cause this means war.
Oh, war you won't, war you gonna get.
Shots, can someone post some damn shots?
You don't need another damn shot of tequila.
Stay, woman, don't tell me what to do.
I feel like singing, bro. Hey, anything, man. Anything. Whatever y'all want to hear, just let me know.
Say, man, I don't think that's a good idea. You know Vanessa don't want you performing, and especially after you've been drinking.
Man, I ain't been drinking that much.
Maybe we ought to ask her first.
Ask her for what, man? Bro.
That's your manager, man. Yeah. I don't know, just in case. Look, I'm gonna run up and ask her if it's okay, and I'm gonna be right back.
Yeah. All right, I'll be right here.
See, man. Boy, y'all gonna knock my head off. See, man, don't you try nothing stupid this time.
I'm not. I'll be right,
bro.
Hey. Oh, man. Oh.
Hi, Gorgeous.
Hey.
I know you get paid thousands, maybe even millions of dollars to sing for people, but me and my husband Cole, we just got married.
Oh, you Cole girl. I want.
Yeah, this is her. This is my baby. Oh.
And I just wanted to know if you could maybe sing us a song and let us dance to it?
You want me to sing? Say less. Hey, somebody give me some. Oh, yeah. Give me some whiskey. Give me some whiskey.
Ooh, whiskey.
That's what I need. I've been telling y'all. all the lovers out here.
This is not what I'm talking about.
Come out.
This is Corey James.
See, I used to spend my nights out at the ballroom. Hey, I see you, Ryan. Liquor was the only love that I've known. That's right. This for you, Cole. But you rescued me from reaching for the bottom. And it brought me back from being too far gone. Cause you're as smooth, sing it with me, y'all, as Tennessee whiskey. And you're as sweet as strawberry wine. You're as warm as a glass of brandy. And honey, I stay on your love all the time. You see, now I didn't look for love in all the same old places. And I find a bottle of the bottle always dry. But see, honey, you, when you poured out your heart, I didn't waste it. Cause baby, your love, oh, your love, it gives me high. And girl, you're as smooth as Tennessee whiskey. Sing it, y'all. And you're as sweet.
Come on.
When I left from down here, the lobby was completely full. I come back, and nobody's here. But don't worry, I'm gonna find them.
And I'll
help you too.
Look, Moses and I don't need your help. We'll take care of it.
We're gonna need everybody's help. Corey could be anywhere in this hotel, or even worse, the city. We need to find him ASAP.
Look, okay. Nobody knows this hotel better than I do. So I will assign everyone a place to look, okay? Candace, you go to the cafe and the coffee room. Frasier's, you go check the laundry. Eric, you go to housekeeping and bring down some towels while you're up there. Lola and Vanessa, you go to security and check the security cameras. And Randolph, you go check the pool. Moses and I will stay here and wait until he comes back. Everybody good? All right, go.
It's time to put our plan into play.
Look, Moses, does Corey go running away like this often?
Only when he's drinking. The kid feels trapped and want to be set free.
Yeah, I know how it feels to keep your feelings trapped inside and never letting them out, never being able to express yourself. Oh, and I feel like I've been dying. And I'm tired of dying, Moses. I'm tired. So I just feel like I have to tell you the truth. I have to let you know that I
hold on.
Michael!
Hold on!
Excuse me, can I help you with something?
Shh! She is going to find me. Are playing Marco Polo.
Why?
Shh, be quiet.
Marco!
Polo!
What? Polo?
You told me to go to the pool and look for Corey, who wasn't there. So we decided to take a swim. And when you swim, you play Marco Polo. And that's what we're doing.
You play Marco Polo in the pool, though, not in the hotel lobby.
Marco?
Polo!
Polo!
Stop it!
Geez, lady, we are just trying to have fun.
We'll have fun in the pool!
Well, we were gonna go to the pool, but we realized we didn't have any towels. So we decided to pretend it was in a pool so we can stay dry.
Marco!
Dry. You need towels. Towels! I'll get towels. Come on. You need towels. Come on.
Hey, Candace. Hey. Any luck?
It looks like it now that she's gone.
Oh, no! Someone else is missing, too? First Corey, now another person?
No, that's not what I meant. I have not seen Corey, but I'm glad that you're here. You know, when we had that moment earlier, I just felt like we had such a strong connection.
To the window!
To the wall! To the wall! To the sweat drop down my balls! All these female squads! All ski ski mother! All ski ski goddamn! All ski ski mother!
Mr. and Miss Frasier!
Can I help you with something?
Yeah! Fold me clothes if you like!
Why are you folding towels and clothes right here? Right now, we're supposed to be looking for Corey James.
And that's what we did. We went to the laundry room and came down and realized our clothes was finished.
So we brought them up here to fold.
Wouldn't you feel a little bit better if you folded them clothes in your room?
In that tiny little box? Uh-uh. We'll do fine right here.
Fine.
Girl, it's easy to love me now. Would you love me if I was down and out? Would you still have love for me? Girl, it's easy to love me now.
Must you do that right now?
Hold up. Baby always sing when he do the
not be singing is when he is 80.
Hey.
Food?
Yeah.
You hungry? Come on. You want something to snack on? So hold on.
I'm sorry about that.
Any luck?
No, he wasn't down there.
I meant with the towels.
No, there was no towels either, but look, enough with the small talk. I've got to tell you the truth. I've been trying to tell you
something. Everybody down! Everybody down! Everybody down!
What is it?
It's a fire.
A fire?
A fire!
Yeah.
Oh, and it's getting big. It's on the second floor.
Can you call 911?
I was about to, but you need to go see it first.
Now listen, Moses, I just want to let you know that I'm not like them other girls. I'm no city girl, I'm no fight, I'm not even a stallion, but I'm a good woman, and I know a good man when I see one, and I just wanted to let you know that I think that you are a good
man. There was no fire!
I'm sorry, Candace, we tried to stop her.
She? It's faster than she looks.
Stop dropping roll! Stop dropping roll! Stop dropping roll! Everybody roll!
She already knows.
Yo, what's going on here, people? Where's Vanessa? Where's Corey? We have to stay focused here, people.
Focused. You're right. We have to stay focused. I've been trying to tell you something since the moment that you got here.
And I've been trying to ask you something since we had that moment earlier, but we just haven't had the opportunity to have a minute to ourselves.
Look, all these people keep getting in our way, and she won't leave us alone. Me?
No, you won't. You won't leave us alone. I'm trying to tell Moses something.
I'm Team George. That's George's
man. Man.
No, don't leave. Look, everyone, just leave us alone. I need to clear this up with Moses. Everybody get out of here.
They can leave. I'm staying.
Way out here, and I'm a darling, darling, I'm all my
have a little fun.
You can have fun later, Corey. This is a work trip. You need to go to your room and get some rest because we have an extreme early morning.
Hi.
You know, today could not get any crazier. I would ask for a drink, but again, no one is working the bar. You know what? I'm going to bed. Can you grab me a towel on your way up, babe?
Of all of this and resist.
Well, you were looking pretty good, Miss Georgia.
Pretty good? Darling, I was tens across the board. Oh, but I must admit, you were looking pretty damn good too.
You really think so, Georgia?
Yes, if you were getting ready to walk the block. Oh, God.
I cannot believe that I actually thought that he was the man of my dreams, the man that God had for me.
And I can't believe how I acted just because he looked good.
We were acting pretty stupid, huh?
Stupid? That was an understatement. But how are we gonna tell the others?
I got an idea. Come here, girl.
No. Okay, okay. We can try it.
Okay, let's see. Let me see. All right.
You ready?
Yeah.
Oh, damn! You didn't have to kill a girl! Damn, just give me the damn mouth! Oh my God, she's not breathing, Lord, she did! Oh Lord, I'm never getting into heaven! She killed the girl! I didn't see this! I can't go to jail! Babe, I can't go back either! I wasn't here! Get out of my way! I didn't see nothing! Lord, help!
Can somebody bring me a towel?